I'm going to explain the construction of the lid. This is bed, this is headstock, this is tailstock, this is carriage. On the carriage, compound rest is mounted. To the compound rest, tool post is mounted, where tool is clamped. By adjusting this lever, we can move the tool post to the our desired position and we can lock it. This wheel is used for the horizontal motion of the compound rest. This wheel is used for the horizontal motion of the carriage, which is where horizontal feed is given. This wheel is used for the movement of the cross slide. This is the cross feed. And then by disengaging this lever, we can move the tailstock. We can, for small jobs, the tailstock need to be placed in the required place. By disengaging this lever, we can move the tailstock spindle and we can fix in the desired position. And then this is a center to center lathe. And there is a three jaw self-centered jack where jaw is placed and it is tool post and it is supported by the tailstock spindle. This is the headstock where we can find the RPM change lever. This gives the powers to the spindle. This indicates the number and this indicates the high or low RPM. By placing the lever in appropriate position, we can alter. The black color indicates the high RPM, the white colored numbers indicate the low RPM. By adjusting this lever, we can give this speed. This gear, the power transmission is of a gear type. There is also a belt type transmission. This is the feed control box. And this is lead screw. This is feed rod. Lead screw is commonly used for thread cutting operation where automatic feed is required. When proper gear is engaged, automatic feed is given to the carriage. This is the operation. This is his half nut lever. By disengaging the lever, the carriage is fixed in a position. Disengaging, it is moved.